And this month is a month which is full of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is full of mercy. Mercy of Allah is very near in this great month. Why? Because you are showing your Lord your slaveness to Him. You are showing your Lord your need to Him. You are showing your Lord your weakness and that you need the support from Him alone. And you are giving up your own desires to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani you are giving up what you love for the sake of what Allah loves. This is a great thing that you are doing. If we do it this way, if we think of it this way, and it's the mercy, it's the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and finally, as for many great actions in Islam, it ends with freeing your neck from hellfire. That's why some scholars said that this month, beginning is mercy from Allah, and its middle is a forgiveness, and its end is to free your neck from hellfire. This is not a hadith. It's not a hadith. Some people narrate it as a hadith, but it is very weak. But the meaning of this is good, because this is indeed a month of forgiveness, a month of mercy, and finally, it's a chance to free your neck from hellfire. Just like Hajj is another chance to free your neck from hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. He doesn't want to punish us. He wants to bestow His mercy upon us. He gives us a chance after a chance after a chance after a chance after a chance. You see? So the smart one is the one who does not miss those chances and takes them. Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, narrates about the great beloved companion Abu Hurairah, radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "I have been given five qualities or five virtues in Ramadan. No nation before me has been given those five. First, the smell of the fasting person is more beloved to Allah than the smell of musk, which is a very beautiful smell. And the angels will keep seeking forgiveness for those who are fasting until they break their fast. The angels, the most obedient. You can imagine if someone who is pious, who is a human, and he is asking forgiveness for you, this is a great blessing. How about if this is the situation with the angels? All of the angels, they keep seeking forgiveness for those who are fasting. And Allah beautifies His paradise every day and says, "My good slaves are about to lift off the burden from themselves and come to you, come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or come to the paradise." The fourth one, that the mischievous devils will be chained. The mischievous devils will be chained. Some narrations, just the devils will be chained. But this is a narration which clarifies that general narration. You see? Because some people might say, if the devils, all of them were chained, then how come we find a lot of sins in Ramadan as well? You see? We say, the Prophet ﷺ has clarified it in another narration. that it's only some of the devils, the ones who are too mischievous or something like that. They will be chained. It's a help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a blessing for us. So they would not be able to reach what they were able to reach in other times. And finally, forgiveness will be given for those who fast in the last night of Ramadan. They said, O Messenger of Allah, is it the night of Qadr? He said, no. But the one who acts upon good will be rewarded when he finishes his job. So it's not necessarily in the night of Qadr. But if you have done good fasting, acceptable fasting, a fasting which was a worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly, then Allah will not waste your reward and you will receive it. Whether you meet with the night of Qadr or you don't, this is the point. The first virtue, as mentioned here, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the smell of the fasting person more beloved to him than the smell of musk. What does this mean? The smell of the mouth in normal times is unacceptable. In fasting times, it's even more unacceptable to us, all right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it more beautiful and more good smelling to himself than the best smell, the musk. If this one effect of fasting, and that is the bad smell, if this bad effect is turned to that much beauty in the sight of Allah, so you can imagine the other effects that are attached to fasting. How about your suffering? How about your pain? How about your self-control? How about other things which are attached to fasting? You can imagine how beautiful they would be to Allah if the smell of your mouth is that beautiful. And then, the second virtue that the angels will seek forgiveness for those who are fasting, and the angels are honorable creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are obedient, therefore if they make dua for you, rest assured, inshallah. Rest assured that their dua will be asked for you, inshallah. As long as you really perform this fasting in the way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because unfortunately, many people nowadays, and especially in countries which have a lot of wealth and things like that, Ramadan has become a disaster. A lot of sins in the night, a lot of gossip, a lot of ghiba, a lot of namima, a lot of watching of bad things, a lot of things. And in the daytime, mostly sleeping. Mostly sleeping. Some people miss their jobs, and some people miss a lot of things which they are obligated to do. They just miss it. And even if they come, they don't work. They show up and sit there, either sleeping or pretending to be very tired, very sick, very this, very that, So this is not the type of fasting. Fasting should not block the Muslim from doing his obligations.